Dan Willis here, and we're talking about fixing your credit and specifically the harsh reality of accurate credit reporting, or so-called accurate. Now, there's been abundant research into this by very many different groups, including government agencies, and they all have very vastly different findings, yet they all agree on one simple, profound truth. There's millions of Americans with errors on their credit reports, and these errors are serious enough to be significantly damaging your credit score. So the next point is that seven-year fallacy. You'll hear this said that the maximum amount of time that you can live with bad credit is 7 years. But they don't tell you that there is no minimum amount of time that you have to live with bad credit. Your creditors and your lenders are not required to report any information about your account to the credit bureaus. Remember, the credit bureaus are private, for-profit businesses. They are not affiliated with the government. They are businesses, just like your local grocery store. That's just information they collect about you. The other big fallacy is that it's somehow illegal to remove accurate bad credit. When you dispute and challenge an item, that is the test on whether or not it's accurate. And the reason the credit bureaus do this is to discourage consumers from filing disputes. More on this in a second. You see, every single one of the alphabet soup laws that I imagine you've heard mentioned or will hear, all those have been passed by Congress to protect you and give you tools to fight back and make sure that you aren't getting screwed with those errors on your credit reports. And we have to take an even bigger picture, big step back. The credit bureaus, only in recent years have they offered consumer products. Prior to that, they were simply collecting that information about you and then selling that off to lenders and creditors. So the credit bureaus, their big revenue stream comes from lenders and creditors. It's not from consumers. It's not from individuals. This means these lenders and these creditors out there, they can charge you, obviously, higher interest rates and earn more profits if you don't have a perfect credit score. It's the individual maxed out Elizabeth Warren. The credit card CEOs and the guys getting rich, those are from customers with less than perfect credit. It's not profits from the customers with really good credit. That's just not the way it works. And the credit bureaus not only have been sued many times by individual consumers, they've also been sued by our government multiple times. The Federal Trade Commission has stepped in and fined them over and over and over again for violating consumer rights, for not following regulations. Remember, all these laws are there for you. It's not for the credit bureaus. It's not for the collection agencies. It's there for you, the consumers. And this last and final point here, the credit bureaus in days gone past, they used to send out welcome ladies. So if you moved into a new neighborhood, you'd have welcome ladies show up with a bag full of cookies. But these women, after they would come in, the only purpose for their visit was to see what race you were, what religion you were, to see whether or not you smelled of alcohol. That was the information that the credit bureaus many decades ago used to collect about consumers. The reason Congress passed these laws, even before they knew that millions of Americans were suffering from less than perfect credit because of errors and mistakes, was because consumers have been complaining about credit bureaus and their behaviors for decades. At one point in history, that was the majority of consumer complaints to government agencies. It was complaints about the credit bureaus. That's why a lot of these laws were initially passed. And it's not just about knowing your rights, because the credit bureaus violate consumer rights based off of history many times over again. You have to be able to exercise your rights. And many consumers feel a lot like they're in the ancient biblical story of David versus Goliath. Yes, these laws give you a slingshot, but that's about it when it comes to fighting Goliath. This is why wise consumers will turn to professional credit repair services. This is Dan Willis. We're going to include a link in the description below to an article at our website for the full story. We also have a free report available there, the 7 proven ways to boost your credit score. Please subscribe and join our congregation. Have a terrific day and looking forward to talking to you again here soon.